Here's tonight's new artist profile of Tony Banks. I wanna be in another place. Some other body in someone else's face. Don't wanna be in here. I need a space I can disappear. I wanna play me a different part. Another feeling in someone else's heart. Don't wanna cry out loud. Don't wanna show you I'm too damn proud.
You've got the new album out still. He brought in several lead singers. Why?
As a writer, it's a great deal of satisfaction having lots of different singers on an album. Nick Kershaw is a singer who was, he's been very big in England at times. I mean, you know, a few years ago he was, you know, he had a succession of number one records and things. I always felt he was just such a good writer and a really good singer as well. The reason I'm in this business in the first place is as a writer, and I never had any great urge to be on performer on stage and to kind of get everyone to look at me or anything like that. And as a musician, as a player, I never sort of felt this was something I did that much better than anybody else. It was always as a writer that I felt this is what I felt that I had something special at.
The door is open, there's a glimmer of light. You keep on pushing it, we'll give tonight. It really doesn't matter if it's right or wrong. The fires are burning and it's warm inside my soul. As we wander down the road, the gift is mine tonight.
What drives you in your spare time or your off time to do a solo project?
Particularly the way we work as Genesis now, where the last three records have been done with music that we've all written together. All the music you hear on the Genesis records recently has been stuff we've has come out of improvisation in the rehearsal room. So the kind of stuff one writes on one's own doesn't get a look in, if you like. And I quite like that with Genesis. I mean, I think it's great, but it means obviously you have all this other material you want to do things with. After the fact, it's great working with other people, you know. But we do have, as a group, we have a great relationship, and we still feel we do some stuff that we really like and have a great time doing it. So we want to keep that going.
You're at rehearsals right now for a massive Genesis tour with an incredible stage setup. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
At the moment, we're still at the stage where we're sort of trying to get it all working, actually. The main feature of it is we've got these screens, three screens behind us, jumbotrons, which are going to be very integrated into the show. We've done a lot of filming and stuff for them, for things to go on it as well. Plus that, the way the stage is set out is different. We've got the speakers are further apart than usual. There's no kind of canopy, so we don't have the sort of black box effect, you know. We've got sort of lights on tracks and things. It's going to be great fun.
Genesis basically took 4 years off. Does it take a while to get used to working with each other again?
We fall back into it very, very quickly. I think it's not like we don't see each other during that period at all. I mean, we do. We see quite a lot of each other and things. I mean, and we are, first and foremost, we're friends, you know. The friendship is based on music, though. I don't know what it is. When we get back into the room and we just sort of do it, we pick up pretty much where we left off. As a group look very far ahead, and that I think is the reason why we've been going so long. If you have a long-term plan of 4 or 5 years and if something goes wrong with it, you know, then it can throw you, whereas with us we can never really be thrown because we don't really have a long-term plan.
Mm-hmm.
Stay tuned for REM next on ABC in Concert.